nkalala alpaka kanya arangwa arangwa kalande alpaka nkalala alpaka kanya
Emily was renowned for painting with a fervor, never stopping to look back on a painting and sort of compose it as a Western artist would do.
If any Australian artist should be seen as an international great, it's Emily, and few people would dispute that.
So by the time this painting was actually created, Aboriginal art had entered the contemporary mainstream in Australia and around the world. And these artists, artists like Emily, whose works were selling even at that time for tens of thousands of dollars, were given the finest art materials that can be purchased. This was painted on the best Belgian linen you can buy. This was painted with the finest Matisse or Italia paints. I'm not quite sure of the brand, but it was the best of the best paint that can be purchased. This painting will last 1,000 years and never fail. This is a priceless legacy. It's part of the Australian estate. The moment I saw it, I knew that this painting would become the standard bearer for the contemporary Aboriginal art movement from Australia. The dynamism of the work, the importance of the artist, Earth's Creation One, in my opinion, the most important work that Emily Kngwarreye ever painted.
Yangan tebana pajara wa nanyi ma no ga garan lalka nangra ni ga inten manen landanak mane elam bi wa painting ni ngwan ni gan na oragan nanyi ma ol yamale gan nanyi male kwan nande ma paimatra ga mane ngwan lan ni kambadwan Nanyam Tillam, what more I'm going to put that every clear line chick. Like an anim, got a canonim and a girl.
Emily comes from a community, so all of those people are part of that story and are custodians of that story in varying degrees. So when you're talking about her, for example, then clearly you have to consult all of those other people in the community who have roles and relationships and responsibilities to what she is painting. For Emily, she's not painting abstract art, she's not even doing art. She is simply performing ceremony on canvas. So she is doing what she would do in ceremony, painting up, doing the body stripes, singing the songs, and she often sings and chants and so on when she's working. And in her head, she is affirming her relationship with Al-Halkara, therefore of the country, therefore of her custodial role with nurturing for the increase of the yam and other totemic animals, plants and animals that she has responsibility for. Now, that's not to say she hasn't been affected by the market and she deals with that too, but the prime motivation and impetus of her work is to tell the stories of her and her relationship to country, and therefore, thereby doing that, she's also telling the history of that country, the history of her people's relationship to that.
In 2008, which was the year after this painting was purchased by its current owner, the National Gallery in Tokyo, at the Gallery of Osaka, the museum in Osaka, organised with the National Museum of Australia to have an Emily Kngwarreye exhibition over there. Now, the important thing about that was that it wasn't an exhibition to show the work of an Aboriginal artist. It was specifically curated and designed to show the work of one of the greatest painters of the 20th century, contemporary painters, regardless of her Aboriginality. When Emily was shown in Japan at the National Gallery, she was shown not as an Aboriginal artist, but one of the greatest contemporary artists in the world. And I believe this painting belongs in one of the great museums of the world, the Tate Modern, the Met, a place of equal stature.
Jar gwa la jan jar jar la jar gwa la jan jee.